about to leave. Already packing, come with me. I'm not really asking. We'll get away to a place where we don't know. About to see the world in action. What we can be, life with no distractions. We'll get away, this is what we waited for. Take my hand, we'll make it somehow. We can't miss out. I'm done living life with the lights out. Die with my own doubts.
This morning on time, and we're heading out for day 5 to Cozumel, Mexico. We're gonna go up, grab some breakfast, and probably get off the boat. We don't have an excursion plan today, so we're probably just gonna wing it again today and see what we can do. Travis and I have actually already been to Cozumel, Mexico, I think.
Our first cruise, okay.
Because I can't remember if it was once or twice, but we've already been to Cozumel, so this will be our second time going. Last time we came, we had a good time. We went to the beach and found the place to get food.
Museum.
And
we went to a museum.
Yeah, we went to a museum. We did a really cool tour. So, you know, we've kind of seen a lot of Cozumel. So, good morning. So, we're probably going to just use today as a relaxing day. All right, we'll check in with you guys really soon. All right, so we made it back to Cozumel, Mexico after a couple years. And we're right here on the strip. I think it's several. Oh, look, Travis, that go Margaritaville. We went there before.
I remember.
Last time we was here, we went to Margaritaville, and it was actually pretty fun. Bubblegum Shrimp Company. Let's see. I recognize a couple of things from, like, years ago when we went. Years. Back in 2014. That was the last time we was here in Cozumel. Yep. All right, we're going to go ahead and start walking.
Yeah.
Water is beautiful. That's for sure. And it looks really cool. You can kind of see already, like, downtown area a little bit. Hey, Kyler.
Hey.
Mm-hmm. Look how cute you look. You wearing daddy shades?
Yep.
Cute girl.
Hi,
I think you look adorable. All right, let's enjoy Cozumel. Oh, the place.
Look at that. I remember us going here and we had like some, they had like,
stuff on sale.
They had samples. Like socks.
So today I think we're just gonna do a lot of touristy things. Probably go in a lot of shops and just look around. Might purchase some souvenirs, maybe, maybe not. We'll see what we see, if we see anything on sale. But today we probably just gonna take it real easy. Uh-oh, White Hennessy. My dad loves White Hennessy. We don't prefer it as much, but my dad loves it. Not
normally,
really for us.
Normally we get a better sale.
On the boat.
I mean, one time we had got 3 White Hennessy bottles. It was basically $35 each.
Yep, we sure did. We got 3.
$62.
Yep. And the thing is, we got 3 and we gave like 2 to my dad and we kept 1, but we didn't even really drink it. Oh wow, look at this. That's a cool bottle. I can't even pronounce what it is. That's cool.
I like the bottle.
Yeah, that's what I said. That's what I was saying. The bottle was cool. Yep. Are you gonna take a sample?
It's good, like chocolate.
Oh, it does. Both of them like chocolate. Of course, Travis is always the one that's trying stuff, taking samples and stuff all the time. Not me though. I take samples every now and then, but not really. But when you are somewhere, there's nothing wrong with trying something.
That's the coffee.
How it tastes, Travis?
Tastes like a latte, like an ice latte.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
That's funny.
Okay.
Yeah.
$38
Oh, that's cool.
Nope. Tyler, you can't have it.
But that's awesome. Travis, what's that you got?
You like this one?
It's like some different, like, hot sauce. I guess that's originally from Cozumel.
Oh, yeah. Now, Travis loves hot food, or at least sauces on stuff.
Yeah, and I was trying to see.
It is cool. Interesting, yeah. And then there's some of them, they got the little sombrero on.
Oh, yeah. I didn't even notice that.
That's cute. Huh. So when we try to get souvenirs, we try to get stuff that we absolutely are going to use or that we know is going to be beneficial for us. But we love to cook, that's for sure. And spices are always important. And this is like pure vanilla, which I think my mom would like something like that.
Me too.
But I don't know about transporting that in airports and stuff, so not sure. Look at this shop. Rum cakes and gifts. Real organic. Mixing real granite vanilla. That's cool. It is definitely hot today, that's for sure.
What's the difference between the two?
Color. It is. You probably want another one. No. Yeah. No, Kyler. Not for you. I know, right? Good. You like it? Okay, back. Go there. Okay, come on.
So, different kinds of hot sauce.
Oh, okay. Not wild or fire. Ooh, super hot. Yep. Hot. We gotta get at least one or something, Charlie. Oh, wow. Yeah. Oh, not beware. Look at that one. Beware. Real hot. That's serious. Hot sauce.
Oh, they're like, you can try it.
Oh, that's the sample bottle.
Yeah.
Oh, wow. One original. That's cool. Heck yeah, you should try it.
Yeah.
Which one you gonna try? The beware.
Why not?
Okay. How you try?
Go hard or go home.
Oh, here it is, right here. Little spoons. Here.
Go hard or go home.
Right. I'm just trying to. I feel like Travis gonna pay for it a little later, even though it's gonna be just a little bit. Travis trying to beware this one. No. Go ahead.
I do.
No, Kyler, it's too hot for you. You know it's hot. Oh my goodness. I just, you tried it without any water or nothing.
Sweaty.
I bet you are. You already sweating when you walked in. Oh, wow. It's good. I'm sure it is good.
Definitely hot.
Oh, man. Well, it say beware on there. Look at this one.
How does hell?
So funny. Oh, look at the try me thing.
Dang.
My tongue is burning.
I bet it is.
Mouth.
See your mouth? So, you look like you're gonna cry in your eyes.
It's not that bad. I got this.
You wanna try one more? Wanna try how to tell?
Nah, that's. Well.
Oh, look, mango habanero. Travis, your favorite.
Where? Oh, it is.
You might as well try mango habanero because that's the one you always eat.
When I used to go to Buffalo Wild Wings, or what? B-Dub.
Yep.
I used to always get mango habanero, but
and I used
always
to
mess
it.
Up my stomach.
I used to cringe every
so
time he got it.
So it's crazy that I'm holding this and about to potentially drink this.
This is original, too. This ain't an artificial type nothing. This is the original mango habanero.
It tastes so good. That's why I always get it.
Yeah, it is good.
It is too much.
And I can smell it from over here, too. I know it's hot. Yeah, it's hot.
I think that's good enough. It's sweet.
It's sweet.
It tastes the sweetness of.
Oh wow. Is it hot?
Well, when you look at the meter.
Oh yeah.
It's in the middle. Medium.
Oh, okay.
So it's definitely not as hot as the first one I tried.
Exactly. And that's mango habanero is like hot. So you know that other one is really hot as that one.
It's cactus. That's not as hot.
Yeah, it's not as hot, yeah.
Oh, actually it is.
Oh. What do we know?
Like if you look at the scale on this one, the cactus one.
Yeah. How much is the mango habanero one?
The medium. It was in the middle. But I'm definitely sweating.
All right, right.
And I'm not outside in the sun. It's
that
just
is so
of the,
funny.
The heat of the sauce.
Well, I'm glad you got to try that, Travis. That was a good find for sure.
Yeah, I'm not gonna try all this.
No,
I'm gonna have my stomach messed up.
Oh, I know.
Yeah.
You guys remember the movie Forrest Gump? Look at Kyler. It's in front of Bubblegum Shrimp in Cozumel, Mexico. So cute. Awesome is this place. Oh my goodness. I like the scenery. Look at the beautiful water. And then you have all the cool shops right here as soon as you get off the boat so you can easily shop and pick up souvenirs, try things. There are samples everywhere of alcohol, food, spices, everything that you can try before you even buy, which is so nice. No pressure. Really cool, laid back. Really, really nice. So right now, we're actually looking for a jewelry shop because since Travis and I are celebrating our anniversary, we actually ended up getting a coupon or like a gift card from complimentary from Royal Caribbean for $200. So we're actually looking where we can spend that gift card, which will be right in the jewelry shop, we forgot the name of it. So right now we're just looking around to see if we can spend that gift card maybe. Now we suspect that the gift card is $200 because all of the items in this place, which is called, what's it called, Travis?
Diamonds International.
Diamonds International is probably like $800-$900. That's what we suspect. So that's why we think our $200 gift card is so high because the place is probably really expensive. Travis and I are really low maintenance and we're not really interested in purchasing things that's like so expensive for jewelry, but we're just gonna go look since Royal gave it to us as a courtesy for $200, a gift card. Now if they could turn that $200 into ship credit, that would be nice because then we would use that, but I don't know about this. So we might end up going up these steps maybe to see if maybe the jewelry shop is in there. Probably suspecting that it is. Alright, so we have found Diamonds International. Oh yeah, just one more thing I'm going to tell you guys. We actually end up making a purchase out of the spice shop. I'll show you guys a little bit later what we end up ordering in the spice shop once we're able to take a break and relax for a minute. But here it is, the famous Diamonds International. We have a $200 gift card that was complimentary from Royal Caribbean. But like I said, I don't think we might not purchase because I'm suspecting that everything in here is like $800.
Yeah,
and here go Travis.
Try to hassle us.
To buy
things.
And Travis and I, we are very much so practical spenders.
Yeah, I don't got time for it.
No.
It's too much.
Travis out here melting.
And getting
so we are probably just going to look around for a second and then probably, I don't know, walk around some more, maybe head back to the ship. Kyla, what you want to say? Yes, the whole world does have beautiful things. Right, Kyla. Yeah, there was another boat. Yeah, so we saw Carnival Breeze here as well, and then we saw another Allure of the Seas, or Odyssey of the Seas. That's what it was. Odyssey of the Seas as well. Royal Caribbean boat here. So it's a lot of different. There's a lot of boats here right now, or ships. I'm sorry. Ooh, a lot of ships here right now. Not boats. Ships here right now. Let me clarify that. But yeah, there it is. Diamonds International. Probably gonna go in, look around, and then, you know, that might be it. So what happened, Travis? You carrying a voucher with no item?
Yeah. So they told me this is for tourists that are Crown of Light purchase, and that Crown of Light is like jewelry that sparkles more, which means it's more expensive.
Of course.
And they said the cheapest is like usually $1,200 to $1,500.
That's a fool.
At the least.
That's a cruise.
And going up to like $3,000 more.
That's a Disney cruise.
And so they said, so basically the $200 will cover about 5 to 10% of whatever the purchase is.
So the taxes.
Yeah. So with all that being said, I was like, yeah, thanks, but no thanks.
Right.
Because that's just a little bit too much.
So like that, like,
but they were nice about it.
Cause they used to people telling them no.
Like, there are some other ones that's kind of like on clearance, but you can't use tourists.
Of course.
Not a tourist that.
Of course.
So those clearance items were like, you know, $800. That's cheap prices. But you can't use the $200 tourist.
But that's cheap, $800.
Yeah.
For a small necklace that I made.
Oh, and those $800 items was like hearts that you can barely see sparkle, but they say it's supposed to be like this.
No.
So yeah. Oh, so basically no.
No. I knew it.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
We didn't know it, but yeah. I thought it would be good to just check it out.
Just to check it out and see.
So yeah.
Like we could take a Disney cruise on that. I mean, we could do a lot.
Absolutely.
A whole lot on $3,000. So absolutely not.
Yeah.
Even if we were balling and had that kind of cash, we probably, knowing Travis and I with our personality, the first thing that we would think to buy is definitely not a necklace for $3,000.
Yeah.
It definitely would be something more practical and something that we can use long term. So, yeah. But hey, no shade to nobody that decided that that's what they want to do. They want to spend that much money on jewelry, but that's definitely not us.
Yeah.
We're a little bit more, we live a simple life and we love it.
Yeah.
So probably real soon we're gonna head back to the ship because obviously Kyla has had enough.
Yep.
And we only been out maybe an hour or 2 hours and she already like, no.
She said her legs are tired.
She said her legs are tired. So of course, since she a daddy's girl, she's getting carried by daddy.
Mommy's girl.
Shoot, you know what I'm saying. Daddy girl. So we're currently in Margaritaville. We've been here before. The last time we went to Cozumel. And Travis just looking at the drink. Or just the menu in general. They got some really cool stuff. It's a lot of souvenirs.
Sorry, I'm gonna try one of the watermelons.
Yeah, definitely. Travis is about to try one of the watermelon. I think it's like a gelatin type thing.
All right, you want
to try it?
Yeah. Your facial expression is always hilarious. So clearly Mariah doesn't like it. Make sure it don't fall off. Put on the back on the paper towel. All right.
Ship, but look at the Symphony of the Seas compared to Enchantment of the Seas, which I think is still a Royal Caribbean boat, and then also Carnival Breeze or Dream. I'm sorry, Carnival Dream. Looks like there's another Carnival ship over there. Yeah, but Symphony is definitely the biggest ship out here, that's for sure. They definitely don't call it the biggest ship in the world for nothing. It's huge. We had a good time in Cozumel. Trav, did you have a good time at Cozumel?
Yeah, me too.
You did.
I like the boat. I like that boat and that boat. I just like all of the boats.
Right.
Ships, kind of.
Ships. It's a ship.
I like going to the
But yeah, we definitely had a good time. But we are hot, sweaty, so we probably about to maybe get something super light for lunch, because tonight we're actually going to a specialty restaurant. We're going to Chops Grill, so we want to save our stomachs for that. So we are going to head back in, relax for a little while, and then we'll probably be heading to dinner. We also have a couple extra activities planned for tonight too on the itinerary, so we'll let you guys know. We'll check back in with you soon. Ooh, Kyla, look how pretty you look. Pretty girl. Yeah, look how cute this girl. Oh, look at Trim.
All right.
Oh, thanks.
Handsome, beautiful.
Yeah, it looks nice. Go ahead and
model. But anyway, oh gosh, okay. Sorry about you guys. So we are about to go to Chops Grill, my bad. We went to James Italian 2 days ago.
Marshmallow.
It's imaginary.
I am doing. All right.
You too. So we are going to Chops Grill tonight. Sorry about that. James Italian. We already been there and it was incredible. But that was 2 days ago when we went to our highly anticipated Chops Grill. It's a steakhouse and we're really looking forward to going.
Yeah, we even decided not to eat lunch to make sure we have some room.
We sure did. Mm-hmm. We definitely did, so that we can have room to eat all we want there. So we're looking forward to it. We're going to show you guys the menu and the restaurant and let you guys know what we think. hours ago we finished eating at Chops Grill. The food was really good. Travis and I actually plan to do possibly like a video on our review of all the foods that we ate in restaurants that we have tried since we've been here on Royal Caribbean. But just to let you guys know, just to give you just a quick overview of how we felt about the food as a whole collectively, because we talked about it, we liked it. The service, and it was just our particular waiter. It wasn't like everybody or anything like that. We tried it pretty quickly when we came in, but we did go to popping time, which was about 6:30, which is dinner time for a lot of people. But the service was okay. For the most part, our food came out quickly-ish, and it was really good. The steak was really good, which you guys probably see a picture of the steaks, and the appetizers slash starters, they were really good. We had the same type of meal on Carnival before. We went on a Carnival Vista and we actually went to the steakhouse. And so we plan to do a really cool comparison coming up pretty soon about our experience with that. But overall, we've had a really, really awesome day. We really enjoyed the dinner that we have because, hey, me and Travis love steak and we don't get to get it often because steak can be very pricey. A lot of people know that. And we had a good time in Cozumel, Mexico as well. I wanted to show you guys what spices we ended up getting because I did tell you guys I was going to show you it. We ended up getting a taste of the tropics. And this is the jerky thyme here. There it is, the jerky thyme. It actually smells really, really good. Yeah, it smells so good. It's a spice. And then we also got the other one. This is the barbecue seasoning, Island Paradise. And that smelled really good. You probably might have saw in a clip, Travis and I smelling them. They actually smell really, really good. So we're looking forward to actually trying those. So tomorrow is actually a sea day, so we're looking forward to that. We have a cool itinerary plan for you guys, and we're really excited. But that actually wraps up day 5 for us on Symphony of the Seas. Don't forget, if you like this video, to hit the like. If you went to a restaurant on Symphony of the Seas, go ahead and comment below and just tell us what restaurant you guys like the most. Whether it was a sit-down restaurant, it was a Windjammer, whether it was Sorrento's Pizza, whatever. Just go ahead and comment below and just give us some just suggestions and let us know what you thought about the restaurant. All right, you guys, don't forget to subscribe. Bye!